Hey guys.
What's up?
It's Uncle Zonky. So, continuing on these challenge runs, and I must say they are pretty challenging as I continue to fail over and over and over. So, it makes it pretty hard to get a video out because I keep failing. So I'm going to be trying a different challenge. Last time I was trying Large Marge, and I was unfortunate enough to pull the catacombs instead of the caves, which of course means it's much, much harder. And basically what happened is I died because I met a room full of fish guys and spikes. And I had, like, no joke, I had about six health. I had 4 health and 2 full spear hearts. Lost it all in one room. So I'm pretty frustrated, as you can probably understand. But I'm going to be doing a different challenge this time, Spider Boy. And with this challenge, you start out with Mutant Spider, so you have Quad Shot, and you also start out with Spider Butt, I want to say. And what that means is you just... Please spawn a bomb? No, okay, I wanted to pick up that nickel. But oh well. You spawn with, Quad Shot and Spider Butt. So you have slowing tiers, and you can fire 4 tiers at once. Which are both pretty good items, but the bad thing about this challenge is you get no... And we spawn double mini monstros. You can have... There's no item rooms in this challenge, so you have to rely off items that you get from the bosses, items that you get from arcades, shops, devil rooms, angel rooms, that sort of stuff. You get no regular items, basically. So that's what makes this challenge hard, and we got hit there. Which I would never get hit on a regular monster, even though I'm pretty horrible at this game. I have enough skill to do that, but it was a double monster. So we get Mom's Coin Purse, which sometimes is good, and sometimes is very, very bad. So we'll see how lucky I get on these pills. Range up. Had 2 good pills so far. Tears up. 3 good pills. There's no way I could get 4. Health up. Bad gas. Okay. 3 good pills and 1 neutral pill. I think that's the best non-Kane Mom's Coin Purse I've ever had, to be completely honest. So we got the seller here, which is okay. Obviously a little harder than the basement, but I won't complain too much. Alright, so we did get friends to the end from that pill. Almost used up my friends, though. Which is something I say a lot of time in real life as well. And a damage up would be really nice, especially with the quad shot. Damage ups are just so good. And we get the rusted key, which increases the chance of key drops and chests. So, there's also an arcade, so I could go in there and play the blood bank, or I could not. It's really up to me. The only other thing to use money on is shops, so it just really depends. I guess I just used a coin in the arcade, so I might as well go in. Might as well. And if this guy drops me some hearts and I get a blood bag, I would not even be mad. So there's 2 plays in the blood bank already. Come on, pay up. Nothing so far, but we can play some more times. Of course, you know, I can get some keys and bombs from this as well, so it's not all bad, I don't think. And there's another play on the blood bank, and this guy's offering hearts again. This is just... Please, please be out. Oh my goodness, 2 more plays. What a bro. And he's offering Skatol. I would love that. Please? Oh my goodness, he gave me Skatol as well. So that means flies no longer damage me. So those rooms that are full of, like, spitty flies or fat flies, they're no longer any danger to me at all. Which is actually really good. So that's gonna just help increase my survivability by that much, and I'm gonna continuously play this blood bank as long as I get heart drops, and hopefully I will end up getting a blood bag, which I would really like. Pretty fly. So we get 1 orbital fly, which is pretty cool. And that is not an attack fly. That fly actually stays around me forever. And now all flies are no longer dangerous to me. So this game and flies agrees pretty well. So I got a key, which isn't as important as it normally is, because the only thing I can use keys for are shops and libraries, since there are no item rooms. When you have a floor with item rooms, of course keys are really important because you definitely want to be unlocking those, but there's no item rooms, it's not as important. So I just want a couple hearts. I appreciate the sense, but hearts would be even better. So I will definitely be uploading this, because I've just deleted so many recordings already. Uh-oh, it's Mystery Pill, it's probably bad. health up. Oh my goodness, what is with the pills in this game? Am I actually Kane and I just look like Isaac? I have had 4 good pills and 1 neutral pill. That means there's only 6 pills in the rotation. So I've had 4 good and 1 neutral. That means the 6 pill is probably bad, but I'll just won't pick up the 6 pill. Oh my goodness, I am honestly just shocked by the amount of win going into this game. Anyway, so I'm getting pretty lucky with pills. Hopefully I won't squander and die during this run. I'll blow you up. Oh, I don't have any bombs. That makes sense. So if I get any more heart drops during the floor, I'll definitely come back to that blood bank. But also, if I don't take any damage and squander the health drops that I get, that would be nice as well. I kind of wish I got some bombs from playing that arcade, but that's okay. So we got a heart drop there. And it looks like we have one more heart drop right next to the sacrifice room. So it looks like I can do 2 more plays on here. And then I'll get some sense, which I can use to play the slot machine a little bit more. Just milking this as much as I can. So this is the one pill. This is probably bad. Speed down. Yeah, okay. It's not too bad. If it was health down, I would have been pretty disappointed. But we have 2 orbital flies now. And I always seem to get speed ups in this game quite often, so I was hoping for like a bomb there or something, but I'm actually quite slow, but my tears do have a slowing effect as well, so it's not the end of the world. Maybe I should have saved some money and went to the shop, I'm not sure, but anyway, I'll probably get some like health drops from the boss, and then I can come back and play that blood bank a little bit more. There's a champion fly, or spider spitter here, I'm not sure what to call him, but so, he always has the opportunity to drop hearts as well. Oh my goodness. This guy is just spitting out these spiders like there's no tomorrow. Please don't, man. I would really appreciate you not doing that. So he spit out half heart, but I was half heart down anyway, so my character is really slow right now. Could use a speed up. So we have half heart here, and the boss will probably drop some hearts as well, because they almost always do. Not always, but almost always. There's half a play on the blood bank, or 1 play on the blood bank, and possibly more. And we get pinned, so unless things go horribly, I shouldn't be getting hit during this fight at all. Oh my goodness. And I eat my words. Oh, almost got hit again. That would have been... Oh my goodness, I've gotten hit twice against pin. I don't even know what to say. I'm possibly the worst Binding of Isaac player in all history. Like, no one gets hit against pin. This is, like, the easiest boss to beat. Other than Monstro. Monstro and Pan, just incredibly easy. So I guess this slowing has some weird effects against Pan. Hopefully he drops like 5 hearts. That would be really nice and much appreciated. Please kill yourself. Thank you. So we dropped a health up, and I also have 3 more plays in the blood bank laying around. So that means I can play the blood bank 3 times because I have a heart and a half, full heart and a half a heart, in the boss room and outside the boss room. So that's pretty good. Hopefully this will pay out and I'll get a blood bag. If I get an IV bag and this turned out to all be a waste of time, I'm going to be pretty disappointed, but we'll see. Or I might just not get anything. Alright, I'm going to spend these 5 cents on the slot machine. Hopefully I will get something from it. I really hope. Got a pill. Friends till the end. That's pretty good. I'll save that until the next floor, though. Okay, so we got a heart, so that's 2 more plays on the blood bank. Come on, I've played you like 20 times already. And we get the IV bag. Oh my goodness. That was such a waste of time. So what the IV bag does is it damages you, takes away red hearts, and in return it gives you money. So it does the exact same thing as the blood bank does, but it can't pay out with a blood bag. So it's really pointless unless you have a ton of red hearts laying around and you need money. In that situation, it's decent, but other than that, it's really a bad item. But what this does mean is any future blood banks, if I can get them to pay out, they will pay out with blood bags, because you can only get the IV bag 1 time. And you can never get it again. So we got caves instead of catacombs, that's pretty nice. And we also got a knight, but it's just 1, so it's not the end of the world. Half of a heart there. I guess if I like clear out the floor and there's no enemies left, I could use the IV bag to get a little bit of more money. Other than that, it's a pretty useless item. So, champion, I'm not sure what these are called, silkworms or something like that. I know we have the Chargers and the Spitties. Maybe these are just called maggots. Regular maggots. When I shoot him, he seems to speed up. So slowing down, that's a bit weird. Bomb drop, I appreciate that. We get a death card, so I'm going to use this Friends till the end and then take death with me. So we got three attack flies, which is pretty cool because I have two orbital flies and three attack flies. Just nice looking effect there. Oh my goodness, please don't get hit by that host. I don't know how I came out of that room without taking damage. And there is a shop there, but I only have 4 cents, so it's probably not worth wasting a key on it. Unless I get pick up a dime or find the secret room and it has a lot of money in it. Other than that, it's probably not worth using. So I'll save this death card until, like, for example, the last two runs that I tried, I wasn't doing this challenge, I was doing Large Marge. But the last two runs that I tried and I died, a death card would have been so useful. Because I came across rooms that were just very, very difficult. So it's always nice to have either a death or a sun card in case you come across a room like that. And that just makes it so much easier. So I guess in this situation I have one. So that's something to be happy about. I get a key there. Heck, I could open the shop just in case I get like, so we get Gluttony, which is a really easy boss and has a chance, not a large chance, but does have a chance of paying out with a health upgrade, which I would absolutely love, and I really hope that happens, but no, he pays out with a heart. Which, if I find another arcade, I don't think you can get back-to-back arcades, but if I did, and found another blood bank on this floor, I'd be pretty happy. So I believe the secret room is going to be here. Hopefully it is. Nope. Okay. I'm definitely going to be looking for the secret room on this floor, because the secret room can pay out with items. It usually doesn't, but it has a chance of doing it, so... Whoa! There's no way I wouldn't have avoided damage there without the slowing effect, so I have Spider-Man to thank for that. And we get a gray chest. And a troll bomb is in it, as well as a key. So I'm just loaded with keys now, so I can probably just go ahead and start opening up golden chests when I come across them. And tinted rock here, as well as the boss, but I am going to be finishing this floor because it is caves rather than catacombs. So I'm pretty confident in my ability to finish this floor without dying, whereas if it was catacombs, I would not be. Well, actually, I'm never really confident in this game when it comes to anything, but I'm more confident in caves than I am in catacombs. So we get a bomb drop here, as well as a tinted rock, which gives me a key, which is not what I wanted, but I'll take it. So I'm just not really sure where to look for the secret room. It could be anywhere. There's just so many locations where the secret room could be. I don't really know. So we have the sacrifice room here, which if I didn't have a soul heart, I would open up, but I do have a soul heart, so I'm not going to. And I'm just going to go ahead and use the IV bag here, because I have health drops in the floor, and there's no way I'm going to lose a ton of health on the boss, so I might as well just get a bit of extra money, I suppose. So I got 3 cents from the IV bag in exchange for nothing, because I just picked up heart drops. So that's something, I guess. And then, of course, if the boss drops a whole ton of hearts and I didn't take too much damage on it, I can use the IV bag a couple more times and at least get some use out of it, I suppose. And if I get a few more cents, I could... Well, I don't know. If I got, like, Pageant Boy... Oh, my goodness. I hope I don't get Pageant Boy. But if I did, I could definitely open up the shop on this floor and see if anything good is in there. Probably not, but you never know. Eat that bomb. Thank you. Ooh, this slowing effect really helps against these chargers, I must say. So I'm enjoying that a lot. I actually really like this spider butt item. Spider butt and mutant spider combo. It goes pretty well. So even though I don't have any item rooms in this floor, I think the odds of me getting better items than spider butt mutant spider are pretty low, so please don't give me pageant boy. Bombs everywhere. Okay, so that's a range up, which is not great, but three more plays on the IV bag, so I got a few more cents. Only 11 cents though, so it's not enough to access the shop, even though I have 6 keys, so I guess I could access the shop. And I get caves again. That's pretty nice. And if you don't understand why my character is, like, getting larger and then smaller, and all the flies are black flies, so they can't hurt me, which is pretty nice. If you don't understand why my character is, like, sometimes his head is really big, sometimes he's really tiny, and see, even the pooters, they don't even hurt me, which is just awesome. I love that. But it's because I have the Liberty Cap, which gives you a random mushroom effect upon entering a room. So sometimes it'll... And spider butt. Oh my goodness, I did not notice that there was a gap there. So that's why I took damage. And these guys do a full heart of damage when they hit you as well, so that's not good. I thought I could just run straight north, but I couldn't. I dropped myself in the corner there, but I escaped unscathed. But what that does mean is if I get a whole bunch of red heart drops, I don't know how I didn't get hit there. You know what? Screw you guys. That's probably it. I don't know how. I just dropped a bomb somehow. I don't know how, because I didn't press the E key, which is the drop bomb key, so I have no idea how that happened, but somehow my character did, in fact, drop a bomb. Anyway, so we get a fat fly, but he's not going to hurt me, which is awesome. How much health does this host have? I've hit him a ton of times. This isn't even a champion or anything. This is just a regular host. He just has a ton of health for some reason. Anyway, continuing on, more hives, which is just fine with me. I would really appreciate some heart drops, though, because I've lost a ton of hearts in really stupid ways. And I have had such good luck with, like, pills and getting skate full this run that I really hope that, you know, I can continue to survive. I don't have my death card as a, you know, an insurance in case I get damaged anymore, so to be careful. Can't access that boss room as I'm not low health enough and not good at this game enough to actually do boss rooms without taking damage anyway. So it doesn't really matter. And I'm going to check the secret room here because it's often next to the sacrifice room. Nope. I'll check on the other side of the sacrifice room as well. I was going to say I could use the sacrifice room, but now that I'm really low on health, that's not a good idea anymore. I don't know where the secret room could be. It would have been really nice if it was in one of those two locations, because, of course, if I was able to access the secret room this floor, it means I would be able to, go into the shop, because secret room usually drops a whole lot of money, and I only need 3 more cents to justify going in the shop. I guess I could probably go in anyway just to, you know, pick up some red hearts, soul hearts, possibly. Possibly a card. Hopefully it's a good one. But yeah, I should probably go in the shop anyway, just because I have 8 keys. I mean, what else am I going to use them on? It's not like I'm going to find 8 more golden chests during this run, probably. So we found the boss, as well as a couple leapers or stompers, something like that. I don't know what they're called, but please die. And a heart. Thank you. I appreciate that. So we're going to go down to this far south room, hopefully find another heart here. Ooh, 8 leapers and some spikes. I don't like the looks of this. At least they're not the ones that stomp on the ground and shoot out when they do that. I do appreciate that a lot. So I'm going to try to use my clutch skills here to do this without taking damage, and I somehow pulled that off. I usually take damage when I try that. 14 cents. I mean, I'm so close. If I could just find the secret room. I have 1 bomb left, and there's 1 good location where the secret room could be. Got it. Nice. And we get the spade, which allows me to skip a floor. Which is good, because if I get Necropolis, I will definitely be using that. So the spade can be a good item, can be bad. If you're really good at this game, how did I get greed? I haven't opened a shop yet. I don't think I have. Unless I have and I just completely missed that part, but I'm pretty sure you can't get greed on the first shop you open in the game. Maybe I could be wrong about that, though. Of course, I do not know everything about this game. Heck, I don't even know close to everything about this game. But we have enough coins to access the next shop and buy it out. So, well, buy whatever item is in there, not buy it out. So, if I get Necropolis, I will be using the spade, I suppose. Which allows me to just skip the entire floor, which is pretty nice. Okay, Gertie. Which is okay. Gertie does tend to, like, shoot a lot of flies. And he dropped a pill for me. And I think that one is a good pill as well. Yeah, so Gertie does spawn a lot of flies, which can't hurt me, which, you know, isn't a bad thing. So I should be pretty safe on this spot. I just need to be careful not to press spacebar, because if I do, I'll skip this floor. And I really don't want to do that, because, you know, of course I want Gertie's drop. And hopefully that is a good pill. I know I had, like, 4 good pills, 1 bad pill, 1 neutral pill. So hopefully it's one of those 4 good pills. I know there was a health up pill this floor. I believe there was a health up pill. So I'm really hoping that that was the health up. I don't remember what floor the health up was. But if I could get a health up, I would be incredibly happy. So yeah, Skatol makes this fight just much, much easier. So that's a pretty cool thing. And we get a double room and we get Pageant Boy, which, you know, I wanted that earlier. I just don't want it anymore. Please be health up. Please be health up. It's a speed down. Of course, it's the one bad pill that I have in my rotation right now. Alright, go into the devil room. And these are deals for spirit hearts, and I don't even have any spirit hearts, so I can't pick up either of these items, but it's just, I was pretty lucky. It's just the Book of Sin and Luck Foot, which I don't really want either of those anyway. So we get Necropolis 1. Ha! Screw you. Wait. Yes, I can just do that. That was pretty awesome. And we get Necropolis again. How unlucky is that? Oh my goodness. Necropolis is my least favorite. I always take damage on Necropolis. Like, when I say take damage, I don't mean just take damage. I mean I take a ton of damage on Necropolis. Every time. So, yeah, usually the only times I can beat Mom is when I pull the caves instead of Necropolis. I usually can't even beat her when I get Necropolis, so anyway. Two of spades, which doubles my keys. Might as well. Why did I pick up the speed down pill? I don't understand myself sometimes. And we get a hanger and 2 greed heads, which, you know, this is a tough room. It really is. I have to, you know, use all of the very small amount of Isaac dodging skills that I have at my disposal. So I only got hit once. I shouldn't get hit again, so that wasn't too much of a big deal, but somehow I can see the entire map. I'm not sure how that happened, but okay. It must be a mushroom effect. I didn't know there was a mushroom that allowed you to see the entire map, but that's pretty cool. So I figured out that an arcade is... Well, I didn't figure it out, but the map showed me that an arcade is here, which means I will definitely be taking advantage of that. But of course, the shop is also here. So, you know, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go towards the shop first. I'm going to go unlock the shop first, and if it's a really good item, I'll take it, and if it's not, I won't. And I guess the spade isn't just a one-use item. Actually, that's pretty cool. That means I can use it again. Awesome. So that means after unlocking the shop, will I be able to, like, go down to the next floor and skip this? Or will that make me skip the Mom's boss fight? I don't know. I don't know exactly how it works, but I thought this was just a Mom's heart. I guess this is a Mom's heart floor, where actually I do have to defeat Mom's heart. So I'm nowhere near powerful enough to defeat Mom's heart, but there isn't really too much reason on... I guess I won't get the boss drop if I use the spade, but at the same time, it's Necropolis, so I think there's a pretty good chance of me dying on this floor. Anyway, I'm just debating, should I use the spade again just because it's the Necropolis or not? Or should I save it for the womb? Then I'd be able to skip past the womb part 1. I don't know. So many decisions. Alright, let's go check out the shop anyway, regardless. Slot machine there. There's also one in the arcade, so that's not that useful. So these guys drop, these hives drop flies, which can't harm me, so that makes them just a million times easier. Actually, the bomb flies can harm me when they explode, but at the same time, they are also slowed down by Skatol, so you just don't want to be standing near to them when they explode, but Skatol does slow down their speed by a lot, so that's nice. And I guess the Eternal Flies still are aggressive to you, even with Skatol, so that's interesting to know. Let's see what's in the shop. Oh my goodness, the Notched Pickaxe. Well, I know this is a good pill. Friends till the end, it is a good pill. And I'll pick up the Discounted Heart, because I might as well. I'll pick up the Bomb, because I might as well. Actually, maybe I shouldn't have done that, because I want to be able to play the arcade a few times. Whatever. Alright, so let's go back to the arcade and try to get myself a Blood Bank. That would help me out, or a blood bag, because I've already had the IV bag, so if the blood bank pays out, it will pay out with the blood bag, which would be great, because then I'd be at 6 health, so even though my damage isn't great right now, 6 health would really, really be appreciated. Alright, let's see, what can we do here, let's make this work, and I got a mini mush drop for this, so that's handy. Alright, I can do one play at the blood bank. If it paid out on the first time, I'd be so happy, but that never happens, so. I don't know if I should just play the skull game. Like, it takes longer to play the skull game, but it seems to have a much higher drop rate for hearts than the slot machines do. I almost never get hearts from the slot machines. Of course, sometimes you can get trolled with the skull game and never get hearts either. Bombs? Okay. Well, if I make it to Mom's Heart, that'll make Mom's Heart a much easier fight with all these bombs that I'm getting. We'll see, though. I don't know. Like, even though I'll get a drop for fighting Mom, I'm really, really bad at fighting Mom. Like, I consider Mom's Heart to be a much easier fight than Mom, the regular Mom. I have no idea what that is, because, like, everyone says that Mom's Heart is actually quite easy, or the regular Mom is a pretty easy boss fight, but I struggle a lot with her, so it might be worth skipping that. Even though I will get an item for killing her, you know, the item could be terrible. It could be, like, a speed upgrade or a range upgrade. You know, I don't know. And at the same time, if I skip the Mom fight, I'll be able to go down to the womb, and I'll be able to skip the womb, too, you know, the first womb, anyway. And then I'll just go to the first Mom's Heart. Or I'll be able to go to the floor with Mom's Heart, hopefully, without taking too much damage, which would be great. Oh, picked up an Eternal Heart. So that's another reason to skip this floor. I just got a health upgrade. As long as I make it to the next floor without losing it, which I should be able to do. Yeah, so I think I'll definitely be skipping Mom. Or I don't know if, like, using the spade puts you in the Mom fight or not. It might. Who knows? Alright, 1 cent left. Oh my goodness. Well, I can't really argue because I did get an Eternal Heart from this guy. I guess I can blow up the slot machine. And I'll get a bomb and a cent. I could blow up this guy as well, but I'll do one last room. And see if I can't manage to get a cent drop or something. Oh. I'll have to be really careful here. That wasn't too bad. Back-to-back spike rooms. Oh my goodness. I can't believe I got a hit there. Whoop. Don't hit me, please. I'm kind of slow right now, so. So as long as I don't get hit by this guy, I get to keep my Eternal Heart, which I would really appreciate. Alright. See ya. I'm going down to the next floor. You keep that Eternal Heart, and it's the womb one. Which is nice, it's not utero. So I just need to do 6 rooms, and then I can skip down to the final room. I get Blast Assist, which is pretty easy, as long as you're paying attention, which, you know. Whoop! Maybe I'm not. Okay, I'm gonna use my attack flies here, because why not? Oh, getting a lot of slowdown right now, a lot of lag. This game has a lot of problems with that. Slowdown and lag and such. It's kind of annoying. Just because there's, like, a lot going on in the screen at one time. This game, I guess, doesn't have the best, isn't, like, rendered the best, or whatever it's called. I don't know what they call it for video games. There's a specific term that's made for video games, I just don't know exactly what it's called. But anyway, for movies it's called rendering, but, yeah. So I just need to survive 5 more rooms, and then I'll be able to go straight to the Mom's Heart. And, Mom's Heart with low damage, and not many item drops, we'll see how that goes, but. So, we're fighting Chub. Pretty easy fight. As long as you keep your distance, it makes it so much easier with these shooting tiers. So I'm pretty much, like, I'll be fighting Mom with, like, no upgrades at all. I'm pretty much just with what I started the game out with, which is kind of crazy how I'm doing that. But I think there's probably a pretty high chance of me losing the Mom's Heart fight as well, just since I'm not overpowered, and I've never beaten the Mom's Heart without being overpowered before. But, I mean, everyone's got to, you know, be a man and experience that at one time, so it would probably be worth checking out the secret room or seeing if I couldn't find this. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I got hit there. I honestly just can't believe it. Please drop me some hearts. Half a heart, how generous of you. I'll take that half of a heart as well. So hopefully I'll just come across some easy rooms while I'm waiting for this spade to recharge. That would be nice. I'm just gonna hide out here. Try not to take damage against these guys if I can avoid it. Because every hit that I take, of course, is a full heart of damage, so it actually would be really, really nice to find an arcade. Well, I have 0 cents, so maybe not so much. But if I get some cent drops, it'd be really nice to find an arcade. If I can find the secret room. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I got hit there. Like, how? It's really not that hard to dodge these guys. But as you can tell, my damage is actually really low. I haven't even killed one yet. I can't believe this. These guys do have a lot of health, though, in my defense. They really do. Still haven't killed one. I'm taking more damage. So yeah, it's starting to get to the point where I don't think I'm going to be able to beat this run. I'm just not in a very good situation, either health or damage-wise. And I'm not very good enough at this. I'm not good enough at this game to like dodge shots correctly. Oh my goodness! I can't believe that. Like, I didn't even make an attempt to dodge that shot. So I'm down to 2 hearts. Probably going to die on this next room here. Yep, most likely. Please don't kill me. I want to live. I just want to live. I just want to live. Please. Have mercy. As long as I just keep circle strafing, I should be fine. Really need some heart drops. Please, hearts. Okay, there's a heart. I'll take that. And I'll check if this is the secret room. If it is, that would be awesome. Yes, it is. Hopefully something good. A whole bunch of cents. So if I find the arcade, I'll be able to play that. There's not always an arcade on the room, but they're quite often on the womb. What am I talking about? There's often arcades on the womb, so at least I seem to get them pretty often. I don't know if that's supposed to happen, but I get arcades on the womb all the time. Don't know how I dodged that. Oh my goodness, that was close. I don't quite have long enough range to shoot these guys. Oh my goodness, he spawned right next to me. Take that guy out. Not quite. Alright, I would have appreciated a heart drop for that, but nope. That was not to be. Okay, if I can just circle strafe like mad, I should be able to not take damage during this. And there's also a champion, which always give some sort of consumable drop, as many of you may know already. So hopefully, that consumable drop will be a heart. I would really appreciate that. Yeah, my damage is just so bad. Oh my goodness, this challenge is just... Maybe I'm really just not good enough at the game to beat these challenges yet. I don't know. That's what I'm starting to think. Because I'm still at base damage. I haven't had a single damage upgrade all game. So, well, we have the spade, so might as well use it. I have 1 heart left, so... Unless I, like, run into an arcade right away, I'm probably dead. Yep, I'm dead. Most likely. In all likelihood, I am dead. I'm surprised I don't know how I made it this far. I mean, of course, the spade is how I made it this far, but... It's still, at the same time. If I could somehow get out of this room without dying... And this champion like drops me a heart, and the room drops me a heart, I might be in business. Probably not, but we'll see. No heart drops. I'm gonna check both sides for the secret room. Probably pretty unlikely that either of them will be it, as I suspected, but I think that was still worth it. Whoop. 2 angel babies, and I'm dead. So, I gotta say that these challenges, for me at least, are just kind of impossible. The only one I could beat was like the easiest one where you start out with the fetus and it's just easy mode the entire time. But other than that, like, I just can't beat any of these challenges. So I don't know, maybe I should go back to normal runs. I really have no idea. Anyway, farewell.